Okay, YouTubers, we're almost done the old snowblower here. This is my second attempt at uploading something. And today, I am going to finish my old snowblower. All I have to do is drill and tap a hole in the end of this knob for the shifter knob on the snowblower. I'll show you that. I ordered this from somewhere in eBay, and it came with the wrong thread size. So I drilled it out and I filled it with a material that's like a wet bonding material that dries hard, and we're going to tap a 5/16 hole in this, and we're going to use it to do the final completion process of the rebuild of my John Deere 832 snowblower. So right now I'll just give you a look at the snowblower. You might not have seen my last video. Pardon me, the audio in the video was really, really bad, so I'm trying a new camera today. And we'll see how it goes. So I'm just going to do a circle of the old snowblower, and then we'll continue to tap 5/16 hole in this for the shifter knob, which you will see that's missing. So I'll just show you the snowblower now. So there it is. We'll do a 360 of the old snowblower. Right here is the missing knob that I've been trying to find for about a month, and the rest of the snowblower is complete. I've actually got a few hours on it now, so you'll see some scratches, which is fine on a snowblower because I just have to go around something here. They do take a beating. So there's the front augers all painted, chute's done. In my last video, it's called Rebuild John Deere 832 Snowblower. You'll be able to see what I went through to build it. Anyway, there we go. And we'll just back up to the desk. Okay guys, down here at my vise. The first thing we're gonna do on this ball is we're gonna drill two holes in it. Number one is gonna be a tap with this small bit. We're going to drill almost all the way through. I put a piece of tape on there to tell me when I know when to stop drilling. And then the second hole I drill is going to be with a 1/4-inch drill bit, and that you would think it would be 5/16, but the threads take up room. So this is the 5/16 nut that matches that gear shift knob, and you want the bit just to fit in there so that when you cut it with the threads will cut a larger diameter thread. So let's just see if we can do this now. I'll get my drill. If you don't mind the weight, it looks pretty close. No, a little bit more to the other. That should work. Now we're going to drill. I put some material around here so that the teeth marks on the vise don't mark the ball. Now I'll just check and see if I'm in the center. Not quite. I'm going to tilt the drill a bit to an angle. That looks better. I think I'm at the base. I'm just going to go, and we always push it too far, don't we? I'm going to go just a little bit more. And it didn't come through to the other side. So now we're going to tap a hole that matches that thread, and this is a 5/16 tap. Whenever you tap a hole, you go a little bit and then you come back out, which gets rid of the cuttings. You go a little further each time. This is called chasing. Once you get it all done and you want to clean it out, it's called chasing the threads. Now I'm not an expert at this. I just have learned over time how to do these things. So I'm sure somebody will probably find something I'm doing wrong, but my gosh, it's only a $5 shifter knob, right? I'm going to put a piece of tape on there just to see if it matches the depth of my drill bit. Here we go. Okay, let's just have a look at that. Oh, there we go. That looks pretty close, doesn't it? So now I've got a, I've got a 5/16 bolt here that we can just try and thread in here, see if we have the right thing happening. Hey, magic! So let's try and see if it fits onto the snowblower now. And I'm sure it will. I'll take you with me. Well, there you go, folks. You've just witnessed the completion of my rebuild of the John Deere 832 8 horsepower snowblower. Well, I think we're done the build of this old snowblower, and I'd like to thank everybody for watching. And we're going to do one, I say we because I included the audience, but we're going to do one more startup and have one more look at this old snowblower when she's running. So here we go. So thanks for watching.